So, as we carry the richness of the past forward, looking to the future, let us celebrate the diverse legacy of barbershop harmony. It is not a monolithic legacy, it is a diverse legacy. In particular, don't try to freeze the style as it was in 19, you supply the last two digits, which is your favorite. It may be your favorite, but it's not there for posterity to exclude everything else. The style we bring forward includes 19XX, but is not limited to it. Which brings us to the second point. Love the old, love the new. You can thrill to the Buffalo Bills rendition of Goodbye, Old Dixie, Goodbye, and also appreciate the Ringmaster's version of 8 Days a Week. They both satisfy every single one of those criteria you just saw. Now, the more I view the natural changes in our music over the generations, the more I appreciate the sound of it in the various decades, including today, and look forward to what tomorrow may bring. And here's a telling observation for people who think there's been a lot of change lately. At the time of, say, the Four Rascals, late 60s, early 70s, or the Dealer's Choice, no one, repeat, no one was singing the music as it was sung in the time of the beginning of our society, a mere 30 years earlier. They weren't singing the same vocal style, they weren't singing the same arrangements. They would have been totally and completely obsolete. Now here we are today, 40 years later, more than 40 years later, and we still hear the same arrangements. We still hear Little Pal exactly as sung by the Four Rascals. We still hear You Can Have Every Light on Broadway exactly as sung by the Dealer's Choice. And isn't that a marvelous testament to the compatibility and coexistence of preservation and natural evolution? Love the old, love the new. Number three, promote quality performance and recreational enjoyment. Probably goes without saying to the people in this room. A beautiful and unique part of our culture is the nearly co-equal roles of singing to entertain and singing for one's own enjoyment. And by the way, that's unique to our music as well. I don't know of another musical culture that emphasizes those two aspects in almost a co-equal fashion. And I should point out that this is age old. Those youth who harmonize in the streets of New Orleans in 1910, did so for their own enjoyment, but they also found audiences in public places. And in that day, professional quartets were entertaining on stage and through recordings while ordinary folks were harmonizing songs in their homes and on the street corners. Those two components have always gone hand in hand. We carry that hand in hand. That duality must be with us as we look to the future. Number four. Look beyond our society to the greater barbershop community. I know I'm speaking right here to our board. I do not wish to diminish the importance of what you do for our society. Of course, you must mind the store. We must be worried about budget, our programs, and so on. But what I am saying is we will be much wiser if we carry with us the big picture of barbershop and realize that the Barbershop Harmony Society, I hope this isn't heresy, is not the sole custodian of barbershop. Just as no organization can claim to own any style of music, it exists independently. I appreciate the way so many of you, our leaders, are seeing the importance of our interaction with all the other organizations, male and female. They contribute new ideas and give us different perspectives and a broader vision. We've had a long working relationship with Harmony Incorporated that has served both organizations very well. We've also existed side by side with Sweet Adeline since its beginning in 1945. And though that connection is less direct, our two organizations have had substantial effect on each other in many ways. Consider the impact of Renee Craig, who through her music and persona has impacted our society tremendously over the years. Then there is the vibrant international community, growing in both numbers and quality, Our current champions, the Musical Island Boys, do you realize they are like rock stars in New Zealand? Most of us don't realize what an incredible boost for barbershop harmony their victory has triggered in New Zealand and elsewhere. And look what Sweden has contributed. Our 2012 champions, the Ringmasters, the amazing Runniga Show Chorus, 2014 Sweet Adeline's champions, and we could go on and on, the Growing Girls, now we have 08, Lemon Squeezy with us this week, Stockholm City Voices, a marvelous women's chorus out of the Runniga area, and we could just go on and on with what they have contributed. It's amazing. I also mentioned the wonderful German organization Bing, Barbershop in Germany, which did something different at its inception by including both men and women, performing and competing side by side, and now hosts at their biennial convention, the World Mix Competition, whose 2014 champion, Double Date, many of you heard in Las Vegas at the World Harmony Show. They're doing wonderful things. Now, I'm not suggesting we change our organization to be like them or any other organization, but I suggest we note what is going on. We appreciate them. We recognize and work with them to support what they are doing, and we find ways to work together. We need to work in concert with the worldwide movement so that the organizations are in synergy. This international mosaic makes barbershop varied, strong, and beautiful. Number five, see barbershop as part of the greater world of music. As we broaden our vision, we will grow and be recognized when we see barbershop music existing side by side with other music in schools, at choir festivals, in local performances, and at meetings of other organizations, such as ACDA, MENC. This very festival is one of many movements in that direction and a most positive sign. We're going to be delighted this week by what we see. Again, looking to the past, consider the way barbershop was intertwined with jazz here in New Orleans and the enriching effect this had on our music. We only strengthen ourselves when we rub shoulders with other music. And when our ensembles branch out and sing other types of music, that is not bad. O.C. Cash himself recommended it. He wanted barbershoppers to sing choral music to show the world we could do it. We can fulfill Cash's aspirations. And in doing this, we bring others to appreciate our style of music. So now let me move to something a little bit more in line with the title of this talk.